How's it going today, guys, and welcome to another edition of Talking Ball. And today I'm going to be discussing the Bahamian Bradley Beal, Buddy Hield. I'm going to be talking about his draft prospects for this upcoming 2016 draft and how I see him faring in the NBA, and also why I compare him favorably, at least on the offensive end, to Bradley Beal. So let's get started. Buddy Hield is a shooting guard for the Oklahoma Sooners. He's averaging 26 points currently on 51% shooting from three and from the field. He's also pulling in around 6 rebounds and 1.5 steals. Now, unfortunately, he's also averaging 3 turnovers a game thanks to a string of poor performances as of late, with several high turnover games, including a 10 turnover game against Oklahoma State. That's a bit of a concern going forward, considering he isn't much of an assist man himself, but it's something due to a high workload there at Oklahoma that I think will be definitely toned down in the NBA. Now let's talk about where Buddy Hield started. He was initially a fringe first-round draft pick going into the season, and he's really raised his stock considerably throughout the course of the year, and he's become a top 10 to a lottery pick as of right now, and part of that's because the draft class is weak, and part of it, obviously, is because he's been playing so well. Not many people can shoot 50% from three, with especially the high workload of around 17 shots a game. From the field, that is. Now, Buddy Hield, to me, is going to be a solid number two, number three option on an NBA team. I don't think he's going to be a great player, but I think he can be a good, impactful player on a solid playoff team. Now, some people don't seem to be as high on Buddy Hield, and the reason that I'm very high on him going forward, and the reason I think he can improve some of his deficiencies, especially his defense, is that he's a worker. He started off late in the Bahamas. He wasn't much of a player, and the story they like to tell is he would always shoot baskets at night, and he'd get kicked out from different places, and they'd make him move because he was too loud at too late of a time at night, and he'd wake up early the next morning and continue. And they finally found him at some event, and then they brought him to the United States. So he hasn't been playing basketball in a competitive environment for that long, and as you can tell, he's been improving year after year after year. So even though he's a senior, I still think he has considerable growth ahead of him. The area where he needs to really improve is his perimeter defense. I think he's turned himself into an okay to maybe, you know, slightly above average defender, but I don't think he's a great one by any means, and I think that's where he can make a big leap. You know, today's shooting guard is a Jimmy Butler, right? A 3-and-D guy, and obviously Jimmy Butler's expanded on his game considerably, but that's what you'd want. You'd want Buddy Hield to be able to play more defense. Obviously, he has the three-point accuracy, and he can take it to the hoop, and he does have a decent mid-range game as it is. So I think he has shown that he can grow his basketball game, and he's become a solid rebounder and improved his passing throughout, but not quite where it wants to be. Now, the reason I compare him to Bradley Beal is because I see similarities in their shooting to go along with their rebounding prowess as shooting guards. Now, I currently view Buddy Hield as my second-rated shooting guard behind Dwayne Bacon, which may surprise some people, but I think Dwayne Bacon has immense potential. I'm going to get into that in a different video, obviously. But I do see Buddy Hield being able to average around 15 points in the NBA to go along with around 3 to 4 rebounds and 2 to 3 assists. And I think he's going to be a solid contributor in the league, and I therefore think his boost in his draft stock is justified, and I think he will prove to be an above-average NBA player. All right, guys. Thanks for listening. Please hit that subscribe button and comment what you think below. Thanks.